The explosive data growth in the country and the fiberization of telecom infrastructure has put the telecom equipment makers in, well, a sweet spot. Tejas Networks, which designs, develops, and sells software-enabled optical and data networking equipment, is one of the biggest beneficiaries. Joining us to talk about the data boom and its plans to tap the demand is Sanjay Nayak, Managing Director and CEO at Tejas Networks. But we also have Soumit Sarkar joining us to take us through the possible, you know, potential when it comes to Tejas Networks. So, Soumit, well, there you have. Please take it away.
So, Sanjay, we have already seen the kind of data growth that has benefited your company in the first half of financial year 2018. But what is the kind of growth that you're expecting in the second half of financial year 2018?
From a growth in the macro perspective that we see, we are really in for a 3 to 5 year growth cycle for data, not just in India, but even in international markets where we play. So as a result of it, I would say that on a sustained basis, we are seeing a long-term data growth play, which is, of course, going to benefit our company. Coming back to your specific question, traditionally, our first half and second half breakout just historically has been that the second half is slightly bigger than the first half, usually between 55 to 60% of our revenue coming second half. So I would say we would see a similar seasonality this year as well. But from a business growth angle, I wouldn't directly say that just because the data increase in first half of the year. It's just, I think data is going to continue to increase for, in fact, the statistics in India is every 9 months, the data networks are doubling in their capacity. And I would say that the effect of 4G and broadband to the home, fiber to the home is yet to be seen. So we are really, I would say, just at the beginning of the data growth cycle in our industry, both in India and outside of India.
Tejas Networks is also focusing on expanding operations in Africa and Southeast Asia. What will be the revenue breakup of in terms of domestic and international business going forward?
At the end of last fiscal year, about 65% of our revenues was India and 35% was international. I must tell you that this year, India has been rated at the fastest growing optical equipment market in the world, growing well north of 15%. So we are, of course, the incumbent in India with presence in all the operators and as well as in the government projects. We are seeing a lot more traction from India this year, not that the international is not doing well, but at the end of the year, we expect that the contribution of India will probably inch up from 65% to maybe closer to 70%, and the international will be around 30%, whereas on the absolute basis, I'm sure both of them will grow. Africa and Southeast Asia, as you rightly mentioned, are very similar markets like India. These are emerging markets where countries are thinking that the data boom and the digital connectivity is going to be the way to take the economy forward. And we are, of course, participating in building the networks, which will allow countries and governments to do that. So I would say Southeast Asia, Africa, and to a certain extent, Mexico and even the US will be focus areas for us. And they will, again, see a 3 to 5 year growth in the data that I expect in India as well.
Now, your margins have been fluctuating in the past, but the second quarter was very good and stable. What is the kind of margins that investor can expect in the second half of financial year 2018?
Our margins are not really fluctuating. It's just the nature of the business that we are in. So we are in a product business, unlike an IT services business. And in a product business, what happens is all your costs are pretty much upfront. And in fact, a majority of our costs, close to 75% of our operating costs, are really related to manpower, which are quasi-fixed in nature. So essentially what happens, our business is really not a quarterly business. It's like an annualized business because you invest in the manpower upfront. So as our revenues grow, and if you see the last 3 years trend line, as our revenues have grown, our operating costs are not growing at the same level because they are more or less same no matter how much you sell. And as a result, you'll see that in an annualized basis, our margins are on a sustained basis increasing. So we were at around 18% EBITDA last year. We've already crossed 21% EBITDA in the first half of this year. From a profit after tax perspective, again, we were at around 9% for the all of last year, if I take even the one-time charge away. And we're already at around 11.5% profit after tax for the first half of the year. It's really the nature of the business that it's an annuity analyzed business. That's what we need to measure rather than the quarterly business. So the fluctuation is not really there because, and similarly going forward, if you see, since our costs are going to be fixed, manpower costs are quasi fixed, as the revenue increases, we will actually see an expansion in the profitability in the next few years. And we believe that another 200 basis points of increase in profitability is possible over the next 2 years or so.
That will be all, Sanjay. Thank you for speaking to us.